clearing. Attendance, everybody be ready.
Stand by. Crash open, they're away and racing, dwelling at the start, Ivonic, and also slowly into Strider's Flower in the Wind. First to get going is Songs and Lyrics from the inside, Gorgeous Gusset, Jump Well, so did She's a Ruler. And there's a line of four now as the Invisible Man starts to dash forward. And the Invisible Man around the outside for Rowilla, sped to the lead, settled a length and a half clear, Gorgeous Gus. Heavenly Miss zipping around them now very quickly into second spot. Back behind them then came She's a Ruler. It eased and took that trail running fourth, a length and a half behind those then. Songs and Lyrics is racing over on the inside next of all, and being closely followed when they come towards the home turn by Ivonic. Further back behind then came Masuru, and then came Valenza, who's tucked away towards the inside coming to the turn. Going up in front of those next of all is Magical Queen. They turn the bend though at the 350, and still it's the Invisible Man, a length and a half. Heavenly Miss immediately under pressure. Gorgeous Gus though is starting to really finish strongly down on the inside. The Invisible Man shaken up by Rowilla. Gorgeous Gus is in pursuit though, with 100 left to go. The Invisible Man, Gorgeous Gus, trying valiantly. Gorgeous Gus comes at the Invisible Man. They'll split it locked together in a head bobber. Nothing in it. Gorgeous Gus, the Invisible Man, in a great two-horse war. Big run by Flower in the Wind from last on the turn. Down the outside there in company as well with Masuru. And right behind them came Songs and Lyrics, Valenza together. They were followed further back by Ivonic. Heavenly Miss weakening in the straight. Magical Queen well back with She's a Ruler, and pulling up back there a long last is Kirigami. Big finish here in the third. Gorgeous Gus, Kesh Duran, and the Invisible Man, Brad Rowilla, have reached the line locked together. Rowilla lifting the Invisible Man, a dive coming from Gorgeous Gus on its inside, however, and it might have been enough as we stand by for the official placings after the running of race number three. Gorgeous Gus by Universal Ruler, and we'll just get the bob right where it counted. Big run there by Flower in the Wind after being back with the cap catchers, getting home in front of Masaru. Heavenly Miss weakening out of contention after looming to them at the 300-metre mark. Number one, Gorgeous Gus, off successive placings at Northam, though, gets the judge's nod. It is a half ahead, one length the margins in 1.14.52, 37.39 is the sectional. 1.211.8 are the official placings, 1.211.8. Gorgeous Gus for Ms. Bronte Wilson, trained by Sean and Jake Casey, ridden by Kesh Duran, beats the Invisible Man. Had the money everywhere spent but for that last bob on the line by Regano from Strawberry Jane, Jason Pateman and Brad Rowilla, and Flower in the Wind by Sebring from Meadow, Neville Parnham and Jade McNaught. That was a very good run after being well back. 1.211 and Masaru in fourth place in front of Valenza, who there was good money for, $8 into $5, and tracking home well enough in the late stages of the race. But it's Gorgeous Gus, after two minor placings in the Avon Valley, that wins its maiden at Belmont Park. Race four, the Glenroy Chaff Handicap, over 1,300. It's the next at 2.24. Let's head down now into the winner's enclosure. And that was a nip and tuck affair right to the line, Britt.
It was, and honestly, couldn't call it on the line. They were aggressively sort of out of sync, but in the end, Gorgeous Gus gets the bob. Sean Casey joins me now. Sean, a six-year-old who wins at start number five. What's the story behind this horse?
He had a few float mishaps as a young horse, and through the years, so Mr. Wilson, the owner, had a fair bit of patching up to do and getting him physically right and mentally right, and his daughter and Julie have done a lot of work with the horse, and then they, because of his floating and me having a truck to put him in, they gave him to me to train, and I rode for Mr. Wilson as an apprentice, and nice to have a horse for him as a trainer.
Oh, it's really full circle, isn't it? Since you've had the horse, has he shown you a little bit of ability? Did you think he could win today?
Yeah, he's worked really well. Willie rode him the other day and said, you know, to continue on, he's got a better than above ability, and he's a really good track worker and just a real tradesman.
Hopefully it's onwards and upwards from here. Well done.
Thank you.
There's Sean Casey. I might get a word with Mr. Wilson. You know this horse better than anyone. Tell us his story.
Well, we've always felt he was a very good horse, but he self-destructed.
Only the good ones seem to do that.
He went over the bar in the float. Then he got extremely injured by catching his foot in the fence and pulled the heel off. We were about to come down. We were sure he was going to run a big race, and he got injured. We're just
constantly patching him up.
Yeah, we've been patching up two of them.
Oh, you must be so satisfied with this result then.
Well, she's had a Terminado and she was a real gutsy horse, you know. And now they've both won a race. So let's hope it's the start of better things.
Let's hope so. And you and Sean go way back. What a long association it's been.
I took him up to Geraldton with half a dozen horses about 30 years ago. As a 15-year-old apprentice.
Was he annoying in that? I can imagine a 15-year-old Sean Casey in the truck. What was he like?
He was a lovely young kid.
Oh, he was.
He just managed to slaughter all of them, you know.
Well said. Congratulations on this.
That's quite all right. Thank you.
There's Mr. Wilson there after the win of Gorgeous Gus. And a beautiful story there. They've had to be patient with the horse who, by his own admission, has been self-destructive, but reap the rewards today as he takes out the Amelia Park Maiden.
Of you touching.